got a rough grind on the bevels. Now what I'm going to do is try and reduce that thickness a little bit. Still pretty thick, a little over 6 millimeters. And then I'll put it in a couple of normalization cycles and do the heat treating on it. After the heat treat, I went back to the grinder with a 120 grit belt and then followed that up with a 220 grit belt. Now it's time for some hand sanding and grind the bevel on this clip after I do the hand sanding. couple of coats of potassium permanganate, and then let that dry, and then basically just clean that off with some mineral oil. It fits up on the tang. Put a little bend in this tang right here so it matches the curvature of this handle. So I cut this notch in the end of the tang, cut the end off of this 10-24 screw. I'm going to silver solder that on there. I'm going to use this 1/4-inch piece of brass to make my butt plate, and I'll silver solder that nut on here. That'll screw in to this nut, which is attached on the end of the tang. Now I've got my guard, my spacer, my handle, and my butt cap all fitted up. Now I can go and do butt set the handle, the deer antler, and then work on my alignment pins on my spacers. my first attempt at making copper Damascus. I brazed 3 pieces of brass plate to make this guard because I didn't have a piece that was thick enough. You can still kind of see the lines in there where I brazed those together. This spacer material, that's actually aluminum, brass in the center, and the butt plate's also brass. And the stag is axis deer.